why do you think the world in 2020 still needs Star Trek so very much, seemingly?
I think we need this show more than ever. I mean, we're in what feels like very uncertain times. I think there's a lot of ignorance in our world, and I think this show really shines a light on it. It also shines a light on what we could be, what we'd hope to achieve. It is about hope.
I think there's a sense, really, this is a much darker universe we find ourselves in. Is that true?
I mean, everyone knows Gene Roddenberry's vision. It's always been holding a mirror to our society. So, I mean, the writers can't help but draw inspiration from the times we live in. However, we still keep Roddenberry's vision alive. It is very much about hope, and hope is very much the message behind our show. I mean, I would describe it as kind of like darker. I mean, we do explore. You will see like a lot of like different kind of planets and environments. And I think a lot more of Earth than we've seen before.
And do you have a message for Trek fans out there who are desperately excited to get a chance to watch these episodes themselves?
All I can say is just you wait, because you will be blown away. I saw the first three episodes and I was speechless.
Are you nervous about how fans of the original series may react to the different tone of this series and some of the different subtexts?
I'm not really, because it's... This show has been made, our writers and producers are true Trekkie fans and lovers. So they, you know, and Patrick is an executive producer. We don't ever shoot anything that Patrick doesn't believe the fans will love. In fact, when we're shooting a scene and he thinks it's, you know, it rings false, he literally will say, no, this is not right. The fans will know, we need to change this. And we stop and we vet it out and we change it and we work it so that it's true and authentic to what the fans will like. So no, I really believe that if true Trekkie fans come to watch us in our new show, they're gonna love this.
I mean, it carries on the fine Star Trek tradition of a hopefulness, but it's a much bigger scale. It's very, very epic. The storytelling, the character stories that we're telling, the sets, the costumes, all of it. It's just incredibly epic in scope and very cinematic.
People love different shows for different reasons. There are people who just like the tech stuff in Star Trek, but mostly what I've come across is that people who are in tune, they feel that they're, you know, that this is speaking their language to them, because they also want to be part of the family. Literally, they want the human race to aspire to do better, and we hope that we don't need catastrophes or the kind of war that is in the background of the story of Star Trek in order to form a federation. And so, yeah, I think there's a bunch of fun stuff along the way, and there's aliens and there's VFX, but really at the heart of it is that we can all do better and we can all be kinder. Genesis was a man who was outraged by what he was seeing in the streets and wanted to join in with the birth of civil rights and feminism and black power and fight against the Cold War. And I think it's always been a progressive show, and it's done that brilliant thing of telling entertaining stories and subliminally showing us that we can do better. As human beings, we can do better, we can be more tolerant, more compassionate. I think Discovery did that enormously in dealing with assimilation and racism and you know, Trumpism in many ways. And I think Patrick had some very strong ideas. He also doesn't want to repeat himself. And I think Picard will be a completely different tone from anything you've seen before.
So Patrick, I think for many fans of Next Generation, one of the key things that they loved about that series was the spirit of optimism, the hopefulness. I think, I know you've spoken about how this is a very different federation, a very different world. Can you talk about whether or not there is still hope to be found within that and why that story interests you?
I believe there is always hope to be found, and although things seem very dark and very grim, certainly so far as Europe is concerned, we have to believe in a better future. We must. We reflect the present day in our new series, very modestly, very gently. But it was one of the things that Gene Roddenberry, way, way back when I first started, 35 years ago, he always believed in. And he believed in a better world and a fairer world and a more honest world. And that's what we try to bring to this.